One of the key points is figuring out who needs HER2 directed therapy. And we had a really nice presentation of NSCBP47 at San Antonio Breast Cancer Symposium in 2017 that showed really and confirmed that patients who are HER2 amplified, meaning either IHC 3+ or amplified by immune in situ hybridization, are really the patients who benefit from HER2 directed therapy. And so that's kind of how we started the talk. And then really things that we need to take away is that the duration of adjuvant therapy is still 1 year of Herceptin. At this point, there are a few studies that are looking at shorter duration of therapy, but to this date, the standard of care remains 1 year of adjuvant Herceptin therapy. What I also want to touch on is what can we do to improve on that, and I'll touch on the AFFINITY and the extended trial. One of them is adding pertuzumab to Herceptin adjuvant therapy, and the second is adding neratinib for 1 year after completing 1 year of Herceptin therapy. And the metastatic disease, just touching on the roles of pertuzumab as well as T-DM1, trastuzumab emtansine, in the management of metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer, and go over some of the new agents in development, which really are exciting, novel anti-HER2 therapies that are coming through the pipeline. In our institution, a lot of what we do is neoadjuvant therapy. So we still give basically chemotherapy with anti-HER2 blockade in the neoadjuvant setting. And following surgery, we used to complete just 1 year of Herceptin therapy. And at this point, what we're doing is we're adding the pertuzumab in patients who qualify for it. And following that 1 year is when we're discussing neratinib with the patients.